Hey everyone, this is David Brown. In this video, I'm going to discuss Dunkadoo. I was the Hawk Watch counter at the Ashland Hawk Watch in Delaware for the fall 2017 season, and we used Dunkadoo for the first time, and I wanted to talk about my experience with it. So what is Dunkadoo? Here's a description taken from the Dunkadoo website, which is dunkadoo.org. Quote, Dunkadoo builds tools to help scientists study our natural world and make science more accessible to the public. We founded Dunkadoo as a nonprofit when we noticed the professional counters at migration sites were still using paper to record the birds they count. After a long day, they went back to a computer and transferred all that data by hand. Thus, our first tools help counters enter data on a device and display it on the web instantly. End quote. In previous seasons at Ashland, hourly raptor counts and weather data were kept on paper and then entered into hawkcount.org each evening. With Dunkadoo, I entered each passing migrant into the iPhone app, and Dunkadoo automatically forwarded the totals to HawkCount. Weather data was also entered into Dunkadoo and forwarded to HawkCount. Dunkadoo has apps for Android and Apple phones and tablets. Data is submitted in real time if you have an internet connection. If not, the data is saved on the device and submitted when you connect to the internet. Each site in Dunkadoo is set up individually. Carol Goodman was our main contact person and was wonderful in getting our site running as well as answering questions and taking care of any problems. She would always reply almost immediately, so the customer service at Dunkadoo is outstanding. Each site is custom, and the differences have to do with what species you want listed and what attributes you want as options, such as age, sex, plumage, or height. Each day you simply log into the app using a Gmail account. We created a new Gmail account that any of our counters could use. You then select your project, so we had the official one as well as a practice one. In the app, there are five tabs. Account shows you what email account you are logged in as and lets you log out. Count takes you to the species list for submitting data. Metadata is where we entered the hourly weather information. Datasheet showed our hourly totals by species in a table. Editor allowed us to edit raptor sightings that we had submitted in case we had made a mistake. The count tab is the default view. So when a bird migrates over, you choose that species from the list. That takes you to a screen where you select the number and the details that I just mentioned. At Ashland, the only data we collected was a height estimate into one of four categories. So once we did that, we hit next, and that submitted the data and took us back to the list of species, and we were ready to enter the next bird. We viewed this season as a trial run of Dunkadoo, so we also kept all of the data on paper as well. However, instead of writing each raptor down as it passed, I just waited until the end of the hour and copied down the hourly totals from the datasheet tab. On days with a lot of migrants, Dunkadoo takes care of all of the math. You simply put the birds in as they migrate over, and Dunkadoo calculates all of the hourly totals. We did not use Dunkadoo every day. Dunkadoo is very convenient, but some people are just not tech savvy or did not have interest in using it. If it was my day off and someone else was counting, then they could keep the totals on paper just as it was always done. And when I had the paper forms, I was able to take those totals and enter them into Dunkadoo. When I was the counter, I always entered the raptors into Dunkadoo myself. If I had volunteers helping me, they would often take the hourly weather readings and enter them into Dunkadoo. So on the days when all of the raptor and weather data was entered from the field, it took minimal time in the evening to complete hawk count. The only thing I had to do on hawk count was fill out the summary boxes, which is the weather, the raptor highlights, the non-raptor sightings, and the prediction for the next day, and submit the daily emails from hawk count. So to summarize, Dunkadoo provided two big advantages at the Ashland Hawk Watch. One, it allowed us to enter the raptor sightings and weather from the field, which saved substantial data entry time in the evening. And two, it made the count data available to the public in real time on the Dunkadoo and HawkCount websites so people could see how we were doing each day. I would definitely use Dunkadoo again, and I recommend giving it a try at your Hawk Watch. If you have any questions, post them in the comments section, and thanks for watching.